Trucks, kings of the road with enormous power. Their manufacture demands a good eye, absolute precision, and above all, perfect logistics. The most powerful engines in the industry for approximately 200 trucks each day. Each one unique, built to the customer's specification in a feat of logistical perfection, time to the minute. The Volvo FH, one of the most popular trucks in Europe, and every single one must be absolutely reliable and safe. Situated just outside the Belgian town of Ghent lies Volvo's largest truck manufacturing plant. It's the ideal location, close to thousands of customers across Western Europe. Approximately 42,000 trucks are produced here each year, including their bestseller, the Volvo FH. 420 up to 750 horsepower, two up to four axles, gross combination weight of over 70 metric tons, price starting at 85,000 euros. The mega factory's day begins at the port of Ghent at 6 a.m. with a daily container ship from Sweden. It delivers the most important parts for building the FH. Things happen in rapid succession now, trailer for trailer. Around 75 of the containers on the ship, each weighing up to 30 metric tons, are destined for the mega factory. Secured with a special anchoring system and parked as close as possible to maximize load capacity aboard ship, these need to be landed and on the road as soon as possible. They contain everything from steel girders for the chassis, axles, gearboxes, and small items to radios, microwaves, and truck engines, all locked, loaded, and ready to continue their journey to the factory. Another key component of the Volvo FH has just arrived at the port too, this time by train. The cabs. They come from Sweden as well. The specialists in Ghent turned the raw, naked cab into a completely furnished long-haul truck cab, customized according to the customer's wishes. Everything in the factory is governed by the chassis numbers. They determine the order in which the trucks are built, which is why the raw naked cabs have to be in the right order here too. And because they're already painted, care must be taken to avoid scratching them.
The forks of the forklift truck are fitted with special protective guards. This ensures they don't come into direct contact with the cabs and scratch them. The freight wagons are custom built so that the cabs fit exactly and don't get damaged during transport.
There are three different cab sizes available and 650 color options. The most popular color, white. Once properly ordered, they immediately head to the factory by truck. Agreed delivery dates could be missed, which would be disastrous for customer relations and their brand image. All the components that make up the Volvo FH are now on their way to the factory. The truck plant consists of four main sections. The fitting center, a huge tire and rim warehouse. The market adaption center for the seemingly infinite customizations and special requests. The cab trim, the large cab assembly building, and the vast main assembly building, the heart of the factory. The truck is assembled here in the 75,000 square meter main assembly building. At the center of the building, the twin track assembly line, 420 meters long. piece by piece, 1,000 workers assemble one of the most popular trucks in the world, the Volvo FH. It consists of three main sections. The steel chassis forms the basis. In the middle, the heart of the brake system, the air compressor. The axles are fitted to the chassis. The number depends on the customer's requirements. Then comes the mighty engine. The last major section needed to complete the truck is the cab, each one unique. Everything begins with the steel girders. Until recently in containers at the port, a side loader forklift now transports them into the main assembly building. A side support measures 5.5 to 12.5 meters in length, depending on the truck version. Two side supports form the subframe of the FH, the chassis. Two workers start by applying a simple white adhesive tape to the side supports. This will act as a guide. They then mount a cross support. It connects the long side supports. And now, the sticker tape comes into play.
It's there so that the assembly line workers know exactly where they have to put which bolt.
There are over 50 different bolts, screws, and rivets, and the side support can have up to 330 holes. Lots of room for costly error. Production manager Kuhn Lehmans has an overview of the entire production operation, and he knows a mistake made at the beginning could have fatal consequences.
What the workers do here is very important. It's the start of production. All of the downstream assembly is based on this frame. Everything done afterwards depends on the workers here correctly installing every part.
A single rivet in the wrong place, and further down the assembly line, another part will no longer fit. The consequence? Production stoppage instead of a smooth mega manufacture. Up to 1,000 cable ties per truck have to wrap around the right cables. Otherwise, it may be impossible to mount the engine or the cab on the chassis later on. Around 1,500 individual parts are installed in 210 operations over the next 8 hours, from the simple unadorned chassis to a state-of-the-art truck. Each of the trucks that rolls off the assembly line here in Ghent each day needs this part. The air pressure monitor, a piece of equipment essential for the braking system. These hoses carry the air. And because every truck is unique, a different combination of hoses are required for each model. A machine cuts a specific set for each truck from a choice of 20 kilometers of varying thickness of hose each day. They now have to be attached to the air compressor. But the variety of hose means no two fixes are the same. Keeping track here is critical, or it can be very dangerous.
If you make a mistake here, a vital part of the truck won't work. This device modulates the braking force, so it's crucial that I attach everything properly. There's a code here that tells me which hose has to go where. This has to be done right. Otherwise, the control system can lock up, or the brakes fail. This is the heart of the entire brake system.
The air compressor is now ready to be installed in our chassis. One of approximately 42,000 each year. Installation requires absolute precision. If a hose doesn't sit properly or has a kink, it will prevent the entire truck working. Done. All the small components are installed, but these steps could be carried out differently in the future. Greater efficiency, fewer sources of air. In an adjacent building, they're working on the production operation of tomorrow, in the training center. The goal of these engineers, the digital factory, mega manufacturing with 3D guidance on monitors directly at the assembly line.
You can see here how it's inserted. As an instruction manual, you can zoom in and check how it's done in detail. The advantage is that you can zoom out to any level. Here, for example, you can move out a level and see where the cable has to be attached.
Fully automatic.
Pascal Meersraat is director of engineering and maintenance, and he wants to use this live data from the assembly line to improve workflow in real time. But that's not the most exciting bit.
We call this here a virtual story. We want to use virtual reality to train the workers on new products. It gives them a better idea of what to expect. Right now, he's virtually inspecting a new truck, how it's built, and what new features it has. This not only allows our engineers to familiarize themselves with a product, but more importantly, train our assembly line workers.
This new technology will soon be rolled out in the main assembly area in order to build even better trucks in less time. The chassis of the FH. It's now ready for a significant moment in the mega factory. Production director Kuhn is present when the truck's frame is lifted into the air.
I love this station. The chassis is now finished. Next, we turn it over and transport it to the automatic assembly line. From then on, the assembly line moves forward without stopping while we build the rest of the truck on the frame. All of the cables are now installed, and after this station here, everything on the assembly line runs at a predetermined speed without a break. This is when all of the large sections are fitted, the axles, the engine, the cab. Now it's time for the big parts.
Approximately 1,800 kilograms begin the next stage of their journey, positioned so that the truck's axles can be fitted. Everything is carefully coordinated in this truck mega factory. Just a few meters away, the most important part is about to enter the building, the engine. Manufactured at the main plant in Sweden and painted an iconic Volvo green. With between 420 and 750 horsepower, six cylinders, which when firing can displace an eye-watering 16 liters. Next, the transmission, clutch, and alternator are fitted to the powerful engine. Now fully assembled, it can finally be installed in the chassis. There's one engine attachment that production director Kuhn is particularly fond of.
This is the I-shift, our pride and joy. A manual transmission in which various elements act in concert to make it easier to change gears. This is our special innovation, the heart of the engine, very important to us.
The secret of the I-shift transmission, it has two drive shafts that are connected to the engine via two clutches. When driving, the first gear is engaged via one shaft. The other shaft already engages the second gear. This immediately becomes active when changing gear, without the usual interruption. It prevents a loss of traction, a great help on hills. At the engine station in the main assembly building, the engine is waiting to be installed in the chassis. It's now lowered toward the assembly line from above. Below, the axles are already waiting to be connected to the drive shaft, and then both will be attached to the chassis. From now on, the assembly line is fully automatic. The clock is always ticking. The engine has arrived, fully fitted and weighing it at 2,000 kilograms. This is one of the most important sequences at the plant. Everything has to fit perfectly. But it works. A wonderful sight for fans of pure brute horsepower. A computer is used during the final stage of installation, the so-called Mont system for fixing the engine in position, individually according to the stored chassis number.
The torque settings for the connections are stored in the computer. If these values aren't achieved, things can't progress. The computer control ensures that the connection is made correctly and the customer can be satisfied.
Now the chassis gets its fifth wheel. It will later connect the truck with the trailer. From here, it isn't much further until the final marriage in the factory is performed. Producing trucks on an assembly, this takes huge amounts of energy. On the outskirts of the Ghent plant, Pascal, director of engineering and maintenance, is on the roof of an adjacent building with some colleagues for an on-site meeting. Concealed from view on the roof is the source of the truck manufacturer's energy. An enormous solar plant consisting of 15,000 panels.
If we want to install the panel here, let's see how it can be done.
The cable comes from down here.
Ah, right. From back here. Understood.
The Ghent truck factory was the first carbon-neutral automotive plant in the world.
We use a combination of technologies. On the one hand, we have three of our own wind turbines, each generating 2 megawatts, and together producing 10,000 megawatt per year. Then there are our solar panels. We've installed 4,500 square meters of them. They produce 500 megawatt per year.
This is supplemented by solar and hot water accumulators and the purchase of green electricity. Apparently, a third of the parts used to build the trucks are made from recycled materials too. And there's also a biomass plant.
Truck manufacture and carbon neutrality sound like odd bedfellows, but it feels good to be able to say that we as a factory are doing something for the environment.
Absolutely.
Back to our truck. Before its marriage in the main building, the custom cab has to be fitted out, here at Cab Trim. The still bare cabs, which arrived from Sweden by train just this morning, wait in front of the building. It's now time to fit them out, each totally unique and different. 300 workers in the cab trim department transform the bare shelves into fully furnished cabs. Mats, wall panels, loudspeakers, all fitted by hand. And especially important, the bed. 74 or 88 by 200 centimeters in size. Many customers request two fold-away bunks, one above the other, as in this case. Rubber seals. How important they are for the production operation in the huge truck factory will become apparent later on. Next to the cab assembly line, a handful of workers are dealing with the truck's electrical systems. From nearly 100 different switches and plugs, they find the right ones for each truck and assemble the instrument cluster. The steering wheel pedestal is installed now too. They check whether all the connections are correct at a test station, and the instrument cluster is powered up for the first time.
The area surrounding the steering wheel is especially important. The main concern is the electronics, but we check every rivet and screw and whether all the connectors are plugged in as well.
Modern trucks like the FH are full of computers. There's one element that's particularly important for the steering. It's a special electric motor on the steering column of the truck. Sensors dotted around the truck and in proximity to the driver transmit information to this motor 2,000 times a second. The result? It makes maneuvering less strenuous, assists in lane keeping, compensates for strong crosswinds, and even minimizes the impact of potholes. Volvo calls this dynamic steering. Silicone adhesive is now applied to the finished instrument cluster. A special hoist arm lowers the central element of the cockpit into the cab. A few screws, and it's fixed in place. It takes 5.5 hours for a cab to complete its journey through the cab trim building in the truck mega factory. And no two cabs are alike. One of the 300 women in the factory works in the final third of the building. Celine Colin from Ghent loves working on trucks. The windshields, one of the few components in the mega factory installed by a robot. First, it measures the exact dimensions of the cab. Then it grabs the appropriate windshield, applies silicone, and installs it with millimeter precision. The unit cost €2.5 million.
It's important that this task is performed by the robot. We need absolute precision here. This is vital in order that the windshield sits securely and is windproof.
But despite this, it doesn't always work flawlessly, as we'll soon see. Time for the seats. There are 12 different models to choose from, all designed for comfort and durability. Now comes the steering wheel. Every one individually adjusted and mounted with this torque wrench. This is followed by the doors, side view mirrors, and labels. But the cab can't be mounted on the chassis just yet. We'll find out why in a minute. Many operations in the mega factory involve strenuous manual work. But the tasks this employee performs, just using muscle power, are soon to be made easier. The truck manufacturer is testing a new technology in the cab trim section, exoskeletons.
I don't think this here is sitting right yet. I don't think you need to move your arm so far back. Hold it up again. Now it's activated.
The mechanical lifting aid developed in the USA should lighten the load on workers.
There are some tests that involve workers lifting up to and above shoulder height. The exoskeleton helps them do this.
Operator Edouard Dumont gets started. The braces of the device reduce the weight of the lifted parts by almost 7 kilograms. It doesn't make Edward faster, but he'll have fewer shoulder and back problems later in life. Back to our cab. Like every cab in the truck factory, custom built according to the customer's wishes. Emre Temiz checks whether all the optional extras are installed.
There's a microwave installed in this truck. This is practical for the driver. He can use it to warm up or defrost things. The microwave has an LED light, 3 power settings, and a defrost function. It has a 17-liter capacity. And down here, we have a 33-liter fridge. It can also be used as a freezer. The seat here has air suspension. You can adjust it to any height, which I think is a good feature as you don't feel the potholes and bumps as much. There's a touchscreen with navigation system and popular apps like the Dynafleet system. This allows the driver to monitor all his trips and activities and store them for 2 years. If I were a truck driver, I'd feel really comfortable here. There's plenty of space, you can stand upright, the bed is great, and there's loads of space to store things like clothing and food. There's more storage space up here too. And there's a mirror for putting on makeup or shaving. You can do everything in here.
This custom mass production operation is made possible thanks to a sophisticated logistics system. But something is still missing.
The cab is now fully assembled, and it could now move on to final assembly. But this one is going to be subjected to a water test. Sam here will take it over to the water testing bay and check if there are any leaks.
The cabs are chosen at random, and team leader Gunther de Klerk is a little nervous before each of these tests.
We occasionally have problems with the robots resulting in a leaky windshield or roof hatch. Roof antennas which don't sit securely enough and allow water to get in can be a problem too. Fingers crossed, that shouldn't happen normally.
If the cab has a leak, they have to test the 10 preceding and the 10 following cabs too. This slows down production in the entire factory significantly. A 15-minute drenching, then it moves to the yard to be manually inspected with a flashlight. If tester Kenfang Holuva discovers even a small puddle, production will be halted. But everything's fine this time. The hoped-for stamp of approval. They assemble approximately 200 cabs per day, depending on the order book. Ours is now ready to be mounted on its chassis in the main assembly building. The heart of the truck factory. Our chassis, together with its engine, is now heading toward the climax of the production operation, the cab drop. 1,300 kilograms approach the chassis, centimeter by centimeter. Everything has to fit perfectly. The next cab will arrive in 5 minutes. Full concentration is required. Two bolted joints at the back and two at the front. Then the marriage is over, and the next one begins immediately afterwards. Our cab is lowered onto our chassis. Following the marriage, the truck is nearly finished. But something is still missing, something from the fitting center. The truck plant's huge tire warehouse in Ghent, one of the biggest in Europe. Over 550 tread patterns and around 12,500 tires covering an area of 13,000 square meters. A suitable tire to meet every customer requirement, and the matching rims too. There are 100 types of rims alone. Special robots mount the tires on the rims, 167 an hour. It takes 63 seconds for each one. Faster than a human could do it. From here, the tires now head to our truck in the main assembly building. A large five-way torque gun tightens all the lug nuts at the same time. This saves time and ensures that no nuts get forgotten. The diesel tanks can hold up to 900 liters of fuel, and every customer gets to choose the right one for his truck. Filling with diesel, oil, and AdBlue, the final operation in the assembly building. One of approximately 42,000 trucks each year is now heading for the finishing line in the Ghent Mega Factory.
Super, perfect, a good truck.
One like this rolls off the production line every 10 minutes. It's taken 8 hours to build the FH. Starting with the chassis, with all the cables, hoses, and air pressure regulator. Then the axles and drive shaft, followed by the engine with a smooth I-shift dual clutch transmission. And finally, the cab with the electric motor for the dynamic steering system. And one of Europe's most popular trucks is complete. But not every fully assembled truck is exactly how the customer wants it. That's where the Mega Manufacturer's Market Adaptation Center comes in, fulfilling special requests. Specialists like Daniel de Koenig are responsible for this, and the most frequent requested? Cosmetic changes.
Remove the PA15. It's to be painted in color 98717. Then PA 20 to 60 in color 2705.
The customer wants to have specific parts of the vehicle in other colors. So Daniel's colleagues dismantle the finished truck once again. Time consuming, but indeed simpler than changing the production workflow in the main assembly building. Meanwhile, line manager Daniel has to visit the paint mixing room. The cab of another truck has to be completely repainted.
Good morning. Morning, how's everyone doing? Didier, can you finish mixing the color so we can paint the cab, please?
The precise mixing ratio is stored in the computer. Almost 900 colors are in stock, making countless hues and variations possible, including loud ones.
We once had a customer who wanted everything in pink. Chassis in pink, cab in pink, all the plastic parts in pink. This was our pink lady, something I'll not forget in a hurry.
The desired shade of black is mixed. 5 liters are sufficient to paint a cab. The spray job is done manually by small teams of workers. In the 3 paint booths, they can repaint practically everything on the truck according to the customer's wishes, even the entire chassis, if the customer so desires. In a few hours, the yellow cab will look like this one here. Black is popular, but line manager Daniel says colorful is making a comeback.
More and more customers nowadays want parts of the truck in different colors. This in yellow, this in red, this in blue. We're sometimes rather surprised about the combination of colors.
But their motto is, anything is possible. Back from the Market Adaption Center to Main Assembly, our truck still isn't ready for delivery. What happens following production is as important as the assembly itself, a thorough test. The truck will now be put through its paces in the testing bay, the dyno. Acceleration, braking power, lights, tester Christophe Trémarie logs into a computer that's programmed with a test procedure for every truck. Windshield wipers, indicators, headlights, horn, and the best is yet to come. Does he still start off carefully and stay in the lane?
First at 30 kph instead of 80 to warm up.
Then Christophe steps on the gas. Will the truck perform as expected? Not far from the dyno at the end of the main assembly building, there's another building for testing the trucks, with another focus, the audit. He is one of the factory's elite testers, David Peens, 35 years old, and at Volvo for 12 years. 2% of the trucks have to undergo an intensive test with him. This time, it's the FH16, the premium model. David's eagle eyes spot something that isn't so premium.
There's a scratch on the indicator here. When I take the glove off, I can feel it. I have to report it so it can be replaced.
Hardly detectable, even for the camera. But David isn't just concerned with the visual appearance. He will be the first to drive the truck out of the factory. ...750 horsepower on its maiden trip. On public roads, under realistic driving conditions. In order to test things that can't be tested on the dyno.
Nu op dit moment kun je zien
The red light at the front there is the collision warning system. If you drive too close, the red light comes on. You can set the distance and decide whether you'd rather be closer or further away.
Kan je eigenlijk gaan kijken van, nu ga ik korter spelen of ga ik meer afstand moeten houden? Forward collision warning,
the collision warning and lane keeping systems. These are the two most important things I test. I also listen to whether the engine is making unusual noises or anything in the cab is rattling.
Where is het lawaai in de cabine?
David steps on the gas. He has, without doubt, one of the most sought-after jobs in the factory.
For me, it's a childhood dream come true. When I started at the factory, I kept hearing about the test department and what they do here. I wanted to do that too. And now my dreams come true. I'm really happy in my job.
Test driver David drives for 50 kilometers. Aside from the scratch on the indicator, the truck is flawless. Back to the dyno, the test track in the main building. Tester Christoph brings the FH up to full speed. Can it reach the required 80 kilometers per hour? Yes, it can.
This truck can get up to 90. Others can go as fast as 100 or 120.
Because every truck leaving this factory is different. Mega Manufacturing individually tailored to customer requirements. Test complete and passed. The time has come. Our Volvo FH is ready to be handed over to the customer. Like approximately 200 others today, all ready to fulfill their calling as powerful transport machines somewhere on the roads of Europe. They are all built in the Belgian town of Ghent. At a mega manufacturer, one of the largest truck plants in the world.